Severe thunderstorm watch is in effect until 9 o'clock, but the main event has moved on through, and we continue to watch the chances as we go into this evening. But like I said, the main event is finally through, but not before leaving some damage. And that is where my colleague Audrey Russo picks up the story. She joins us now from Chicopee. Audrey, what are you seeing in your area?
Jacob, here on Meeting House Road, you can see the middle of the road, essentially a lake. Officials not letting folks drive through. And believe it or not, what you see out there has actually recessed from what we saw when we were here earlier. You can actually see this line where the pavement is dry. This is where the flooding was. And this is only a fraction of the flooding and damage that we've seen here in Chicopee. Take a look at this. Over on Chicopee Street, a tree draped across power lines. Folks who live in the area tell me that their power is gone and that they actually heard the tree crack. They tell me it sounded like a gunshot. Over near Marshall and Elmer, Western Mass News cameras captured severe flooding near a different housing complex. Back here on Meeting House Road, some people tried to take a detour onto this street, actually, to avoid some of the other damage in the area. One driver I spoke with said his car couldn't make it through the water.
As soon as we got in the middle and it got past the flooding point of the airbox, it just started killing the motor. And I switched the car off and then decided to push myself out from there.
Again, this road is now closed for drivers trying to make their way through. We saw earlier, actually just before this broadcast, we saw folks with emergency management using a drone to survey the damage in the city. We'll have more on some of the trees that are down in other parts of the area coming up later on Western Mass News. But for now, I'm reporting live in Chicopee, Audrey Russo for Western Mass News.
Audrey, thank you. This was the scene in Longmeadow less than an hour ago. Crews responding after a tree fell onto some power lines there. Officials say at one point nearly 650 customers were without power in town after the storm rolled through. That number is down to just about 20 right now.